three, give her the six, top of the six.
Está buena.
Regis or Zepeda? Peter picked Regis.
Regis or Zepeda? I don't know. Zepeda is hard, man. It's going to be a tough fight. Tough fight.
Who do you like, Chepe?
Hey, Regis.
You guys like Regis? Regis or Zepeda?
Regis.
I'm going to say Regis.
Everybody else, you know, every other gym, everybody picks Zepeda. That's interesting. Hey, Ryan or Tank?
Tank.
Why?
It's too hard.
I'm on the cusp on this one, but I'm going to go with Garcia. The speed and that hook.
Chepe, Tank or Ryan?
Tank.
Tank.
Robert got Ryan on this one. Pantera, Tank or Ryan? You know, I need to ask Ray Murataya. He fought Ryan 4 times in amateurs, right? 5 times?
Raymond, yeah. Like 4 times. He's not here yet.
He's not here? Where is he at? Come later. He's very talented. I think he's one of the biggest secrets in boxing at 135. He's a beast.
He's a great fighter. I think next fight, November 12th, next year, I think we
will be his year.
We're planning on putting something with Brad for early next year. He's going to make a statement in that fight.
And then
end of the year, he'll be ready, getting ready for
he'll be a champ.
I think he's that good. He is really good.
Shakur and Haney, who wins, Robert?
Shakur, Haney. I think Shakur's. Haney's probably too big for Shakur. Because I think Shakur's a featherweight, but he's moving up in weight, obviously.
Shakur's big too.
Is he? Tall? I think Haney's
like lengthwise and stuff. No, they're picturing each other.
They're
mm-hmm.
the same height.
He's not a small 130.
I would pick Shakur.
Shakur? You got Shakur?
Well, I think so too.
Shakur or Haney?
But I think Haney's too big, no? You don't think Haney's too big for
it's him? A very technical fight.
Yeah, it wouldn't be the most exciting fight ever. Fuck no. But
what about Loma and Haney?
It's tough, man.
Loma and Haney?
I think Haney at this time. I think Loma is the small one.
Loma's small. Shakur and Haney would both beat him, I think. I think Shakur.
You know what I think? You know who I think? Could probably
beat most of the Javante
Davis? No. Fucking
Pitbull. You think so? Pitbull Crew?
That style.
Against who, Robert? Like him and Haney?
135.
Haney? Pitbull?
Him and
Shakur?
For 12 fuckers, he probably won't touch him for the first 3 or 4 rounds. But he'll fucking catch him.
He wouldn't touch
what?
Him.
What? Does he knock out Haney?
Eventually. He swings one wild punch at a time. That's not gonna land on those guys. You're thinking of him as like a
Tank.
Fucking boom, 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 boom. Tank, that's what Tank did.
Tank had one hand, Robert. Tank had one hand. Tank had one hand. Tank had one hand. He had a broken hand going into the fight.
But Tank is nowhere near the level of Shakur or Devin Haney in terms of his defense. He's a power punch and he's fast, but his defense isn't like Shakur's.
Neither was Chino and Broner, and neither was Chino and the way his styles make fights.
Okay, Maidana throws a lot of punches. Maidana's throwing fucking.
Oh, Kido does too?
No, he doesn't. He throws like two.
He throws a lot. No, he does. He's a punching machine. No. He throws nonstop.
He fights Shakur. Shakur's going to beat him 10 to 2.
Well, they might beat him. Oh, fuck no.
He fights Devin Haney.
He smells.
Maybe Devin, he'll give Devin Haney a little bit. But no, 9 rounds to 3. Nah, he's not touching him. He throws one hard punch at a time.
Very close fight. All of them.
You said he gives trouble to anybody.
I think he gives trouble to any lightweight. He does. Gives trouble to any lightweight.
He's a hard. You know, his grandfather was a fighter. His dad was a fighter. He was born in the boxing.
What did his dad fight?
Vernon Forrest?
And a big guy.
Or Pernell Whitaker, one of those. Yeah. Regis Zepeda, November 26th. Who wins?
I think I'm leaning towards Regis.
You're one of the few people picking it. Everybody else picks Zepeda. Why Regis?
I think Zepeda is on a... unless I could be wrong, because Regis hasn't fought in a while. He hasn't fought a top-level guy in a while either. But I think Zepeda had kind of like a... Like, it went... Like, that one Jose Vargas fight just went perfect for him. And it was against somebody, Jose, who was honestly never like a threat at 140. The fight before that, he had a bad
He had a bad fight when he fought on Jose's undercard, when he fought Josh Taylor. Then he goes and he does that one-punch knockout against Josue, which blew him up. And then he goes and fights in Mexico. I didn't even see the fight that he had in Mexico. But I just don't... I don't know, man.
You got Regis.
I got Regis.
Who in this gym could give him a good fight?
We have Lindolfo. We have Lindolfo.
Where's Jose?
Jose...
He's getting married?
Yeah, he's getting married in a few weeks. Xavier, what up?
What's up, Xavier? Man, you look like a man with that beard. You got to shave that. Hey, Antonio, if you look like Abraham Lincoln, who does he look like with a beard?
Mine was pretty bad,
I think
though,
he more looks more like Lincoln than me.
You look more like Abraham Lincoln?
I guess so, shit.
But Lincoln was like 6'6".
He was?
Yeah, he
really. Did you know that Lincoln was 6'6"?
Was it?
He? Hey, you want to hear some crazy facts? The guy who shot Lincoln was named Kennedy. The guy who shot Kennedy was named Lincoln. True story. Lincoln was shot from a library, and Kennedy was shot from a theater. Like basically, oh, yeah, yeah. Like a lot of similarities between the two of them. Crazy. I read a whole article comparing.
Yeah.
It's really weird. Yeah, look into it. Lincoln compared to Kennedy assassination. Pita, have you seen the Netflix show about Jeffrey Dahmer?
No.
Have you seen it?
The first episode.
Was it good?
Yeah, it was good.
Why'd everybody say to cancel it? I haven't seen it. Why is it good?
The story, like, I saw on Twitter a lady that said, a lady, I don't know what, you know,
yeah.
But she was complaining about how her family was one of the families that was affected when
the
that
victims?
Actually happened.
Wow.
And she said it just brings back bad memories, so why the fuck are they doing it?
Well,
and
they're not paying
and
them.
They're not doing it on purpose, but I guess the actor's doing such a good job from what I've seen
yeah.
in the role that they're, like, giving him, like, it's making it look like, oh, shit, like, he's, you know, I don't know.
I hear it's like super accurate.
Like, yeah, like the romanticized. Like,
where was he from originally?
Milwaukee.
Hey! Jeffrey Dahmer was your neighbor. You're lucky. You're lucky. Hey, what would you do if Jeffrey Dahmer said, I want to eat you?
Gabriel, start getting ready.
Jeffrey Dahmer was a cannibal. He used to eat people.
He used to hunt gay people.
I don't know. I didn't know. I don't know the story.
Nah, man.
Jeffrey Dahmer's from Milwaukee, but John Wayne Gacy did time in Iowa. And John Wayne Gacy got more bodies.
Pita, did you know he was from Milwaukee?
No, I didn't know.
I didn't know. Did you know he was from Milwaukee?
Yeah. Of course.
Robert, who's the... Let me see if Robert knows. I don't think you would know the answer. Who's the most famous person in the history of Milwaukee?
Milwaukee?
Yes, the most famous.
Shit, Milwaukee?
Yes, not an athlete.
A person in Milwaukee?
Super famous.
Just came out on Netflix.
From Milwaukee?
Yes.
He's got an unusual diet.
That
fool
was eating people? Or what?
Yeah, that's him. Jeffrey Dahmer.
Yeah, he was from Milwaukee?
Yes.
Yeah?
What? Hey,
you guys don't have Subways over there or some McDonald's over there? He has to eat people? How crazy is that?
I heard about it. I haven't seen it. I'm not sure.
You know who saw it? Antonio saw it. He said it was good.
That's not a
gay show. I haven't seen it.
Them,
and then he eats them?
Well, he kills them and then he fucking chops them up.
That's terrible.
And he ate a couple of them.
What's wrong with people?
Sick.
That's what happened. Ellie Sekback, reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback, reporting. ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback, reporting.